Welcome back to Amazons, where we are talking with the Executive Governor of Oyo State, Senator Abiola Ajimobi. Your Excellency, your first 2 years in office, you were welcomed by flood, disaster of flood, the Ogunpa overflowing, people being killed, swept away, and properties destroyed. The Ogunpa River, a perennial problem for the people of Ibadan. Have you been able to identify the cause? Because I know that the World Health Organization is also interested in the, you know, how to manage flood in Ibadan. What measures have you taken, especially with the global warming and the intense rainfall? How have you been able to manage the flood in Ibadan?
I think, like all things, you know, there are three ways of dealing with a problem. You can either solve it in its present position. You can recontext the problem. Or you can dissolve the problem. I think what we've done in the case of flooding is to try to recontext the problem. How? Ogunpa River, of course, has so many tributaries, you know, from different areas, angles. And the first thing we discovered was that people throw waste, refuse, inside the stream. And anytime it rains, it's the culture. Oh, take all your refuse, go and pour it inside the stream. The river will wash it away. We've started changing that culture. I'm telling people, bring your refuse on the median of the street. Two, there were many buildings on the floodplain. People will just build anyhow. They've disturbed the flow of the river. And you see that water will always find its level. We always find its way. So we identified those buildings on the floodplain. We also discovered that many of the streams or even the rivers were already silted. So we started desilting it, you know, removing sand, removing mud from, and we are dredging. So far, we have dredged 43 rivers.
Wow.
In the state.
I went to University of Ibadan, so I'm also particular about education in Oyo State. And we know that we are pioneers when we're talking about free education policy under UPN, which was also under Paolo. And now, if we're looking at the results, statistics that we have from the WAEC of 2011, it says that out of 36 states, we ranked 34. Ibadan, Oyo State ranked 34. What are we doing? What is being done about this?
You see, again, education, I think, has about three parts. It has the teacher, the quality of the teacher, the student, the health of the student, the mental state of the student, the appearance, the are they well fed or not, are they being taken care of or not. And then it has the infrastructure, which is the school, the building, the chairs, the furniture. Since we came in, before we came in, we were in the 34th position. By last year, 2012, we came to 23rd position.
Great.
And for the first time, we are introducing a university that we call the Technical University of Oyo State in Ibadan here. It's a school that is unique, that is not like it in Nigeria.
Another first.
Yes. And that school, why is it the first of its kind in Nigeria? Is the fact that you do 2 years here, in Nigeria, in technical, in areas like biometrics, in sciences, robotics, in unusual, unique areas. You do 2 years here, and you go and do 2 years in Texas. We have an agreement with you.
Like an exchange program.
Yeah.
What is in place for the Ibadan people, what should I say, or your state woman or Ibadan woman? Especially in terms of health, in terms of mothers, in terms of young girls' education, are there anything that you're doing to sort of like, you know, encourage women to be, you know, to participate more?
First and foremost, it would be unforgivable of me if I don't pay special attention to women. Why? Because I have 5 children, 4 girls, 1 boy. So that basically gives me a soft spot for women. I think we've also introduced this ABIE program, which is similar to what they are doing in Ondo State, which is also for mothers, for pregnant women. We give them free medication to a certain level. We take care of them. We are doing that. I think that is on health ground. But when it comes to empowerment, we've done a lot, believe me. Every month, my wife distributes machines, different, what do they call it, this air dressing,
dryers
and so on and so forth. So we are doing a lot for women in that. Even every month she distributes food items, every month. And then if you watch television, you see a lot of old women, everybody going, you hardly see men there, no man.
What about in your administration? How many women do you have?
Well, I have so many.
We know that the speaker is a woman.
The speaker is a woman. Though I didn't appoint the speaker, but
I supported her.
I contributed to her emergence. We have the chief judge of the state is a woman. I didn't appoint her, but that's also the second thing. Then, apart from that, my commissioners and special advisors, I have a lot of women there, a lot of them. At least we have 30% women. Yeah, so it's a lot of them,
You were talking about mobile clinics, and that just reminded me, tricycles and ambulances.
Yeah, you see, my own understanding of development is that you must look at your environment and you must prefer solutions that are environmentally friendly. Tricycles. Those tricycles are specially made for us. Not the tricycles you see on the street, not the keke napep. No. We had to import them.
Okay.
We give them designs. And if you see them, very good. They are workable instruments for the area. There are areas where ambulances cannot get to. Those tricycles will get there for easier accessibility. We are using the tricycles for maneuverability. We are using the tricycles, and simply, if you see them, you like them. And we are supporting those tricycles with real ambulances, with vehicles, big vehicles. Okay. So we have these for, okay, and that tricycle, or let me say the tricycles, they have saved many lives.
I can imagine.
You would not believe it. There are some, you know, Ibadan, hilly place with so many corners. You know, from where I am here in the government house, Ibadan is such a city that you can enter one corner and you can go through the corner for the next 3-4 miles without getting to the main road.
True. We did that today.
So when you have a place like that, you need tricycles, specially built tricycles. And for me, I think it's people talk about homegrown solutions. That is homegrown.
Yeah, we're still speaking with the executive governor of Oyo State, Senator Abiola Ajimobi, on the Amazons today. When we come back, we will be talking about the wild, wild west on the Amazons.
Followership will always go in line with the leadership when properly managed.